Hi, I'm Anita Coe, and I'm the medical director of the Spinal Cord Injury Program at the Northwestern Medicine Marianjoy Rehabilitation Hospital. So we had this opportunity to treat a Spanish-speaking patient who came to us after being in a motor vehicle accident. He had suffered spine fractures, including a T5 Asia Impairment Score B, incomplete paraplegia. When he came to us, he really had no movement in his lower extremities. He had also what we'd call neurogenic bladder, retaining urine, neurogenic bowel, as well as having neuropathic pain and spasticity. Some of the unique ways we were able to treat this patient was incorporate electrical stim or neuromuscular electrical stim, NMES, where our physical therapist would apply that to his quadriceps muscles. And initially there was no response, but by the time he discharged, we were starting to get some trace movement, which was very exciting for him and his family. After this patient completed about 6 weeks of inpatient rehab, he did start home health therapies. When he followed up eventually in our clinic at the 1 month time period, we got him transitioned to outpatient PT and OT here at Marianjoy with our day rehab program. And there he was able to make even more gains. I was seeing that he was able to start walking with less assistance, about contact guard assist, about 100 feet. He was starting to initiate stairs and even doing some leg presses. He also accessed Marianjoy specialty programs, our prosthetic and orthotic clinic, our wheelchair seating and positioning clinic, and even our health and fitness center. In our program, we have dedicated therapists who are great at communicating with me. Similarly, nursing was very good at knowing what to expect with his bladder and bowel care and any changes that we would want to work together on to make sure that he was continent. Some extra measures that we took to help make sure communication was excellent with our patient, including utilizing our in-person Spanish interpreter services as well as telehealth for, you know, maybe evening shift or an overnight shift with staff. And we also used in-person interpreter services during rounds and therapy sessions. Really amazing that this patient who presented initially to our program with no movement to able to ambulate with a rolling walker and some braces, but you know, able to do that with very little assistance. I'm excited for him, just seeing the progress he made in those first 5 to 6 months. He was at a AISB, a classification of incomplete paraplegia, and I'm hopeful that he's going to be able to be independent, maybe walking with a straight cane in the future. I feel very honored and just proud of our team to be a part of these individuals who come through our program who, you know, given such a devastating diagnosis, but we're able to kind of rally around them and show them that they can achieve and overcome barriers to have a very successful life afterwards.